take a walk down by the sea, picking up colored shells in the sand. Seagull, I want your wings, silver circus in a cloudy land. Even when the winds blow lonely, lightning cracks the black sky's face, seagull, I can hear you calling.
Hey guys, I'm making my plum jam tonight. This is 3 quarts of our plums that we've processed and de-pitted, and they are the native plums to this area in the southeast, which are got many names: Chickasaw plums, Santa Rosa plums. I think even in Texas and out Midwest, Oklahoma area, they call them sand plums. But right now we're gonna cook this down and show you what we do when we make this jam. And right here I have another quart, and then there'll be another 3 quarts total. But I'm gonna show you something else. Check that out. This is our grapes this year. You can see, like this one, got a little pinkish color to them. This is our third batch, and we're gonna be making grape juice with them. And when I do that, I'll show you that video. But for now, we're cooking this plum nectar. It's a juice. They've been juiced and they got pulp in it, which it's not gonna be jelly, it's gonna be a jam. So it'll be a little bit different process than when I do the jelly. It's basically the same, but it's just gonna turn out, it'll be like a preserve, or it'll be a jam. It'll have all the extra stuff in it versus just juice like when I do the rose jelly. So stay tuned and hang on, we'll show you a little more in a little while. All right guys, this is my pectin. That's 2 packs of my sure gel. What I do is, instead of just pouring it in there, add a little sugar to it. I'm gonna take a fork, I let it stir that in to mix the sugar into the pectin. And what it does is it helps it to keep the pectin from just making like lumps when you pour it in. So now I'm gonna add the pectin. Keep stirring. Put it all in there. I got it here. All right, I'm gonna stir that in for a few minutes till that all dissolves, because you can't see it because of the pulp and everything and the plum juice in there. It's getting pretty warm. I've got my heat. You can see that little flame. It's a little small flame, but I don't want it to just get scorching hot. So we'll bring the heat up slowly. After a few minutes of stirring this in, so I can still feel the sugar in the bottom and the pectin, I'll turn the heat up a little bit and constantly stir it. And I'll add my 8 cups of sugar to it. The plums have quite a bit of sugar sweetness to them, so I'm not going to put 9 cups of sugar in this. So yeah, it has a peach kind of smell to it. Plums and peaches kind of in the same family. When I get the sugar added in it, I'll show you what I do then. All right guys, we're at the point where I'm gonna add the sugar. And if you'll just stir that, just constantly stir it when I pour it in with your hand.
more.
Okay. I did. And the sugar's in. And it's gonna cook in here for quite a while before it gets to the raging boil like I get it to. We're waiting on the water to come to a boil. I have my jars in the oven like I do. I put them on at 350. They'll be in there for about 25-30 minutes. Ain't nothing gonna survive in there. They're clean. Jars have been washed in the dishwasher. Just fill it up. The jar has been washed in the dishwasher, so I just go an extra precaution to putting them in the oven and cooking them. Look how the color of this went from kind of an orange to a burgundy, and it got a little more clear. Always like to watch it when that sugar goes in. But right now, I'm gonna be stirring for a while, so I don't wanna bore you with that. I'm gonna stir it when it comes to that boil. Where you can see, like it does when I do my other jellies, it'll get way up to like right there where that spoon's touching. And then I'll boil that for another 2 minutes. Then I'll take it out, turn the heat off, and start putting it in the jar. Here we're putting the lids.
It's a hand thing.
In the little catcher thing right there. I don't know what it's called. It's just a little lid.
I don't know, but
holder.
It's handy.
See, if you start them on this end and move that way, so you ain't got that handle in the way when you're trying to put them in there.
Oh, of course.
But it works real good, so you ain't got to dig can lids out of a little pot of boiling water.
Can't seem to find
the way we do it here at Mingo's Moondo. We have like a little urban homestead type of thing going on here. We have a lot of fruit trees in the yard, and we go pick berries and all different stuff. We have chickens, and we're looking for some land in the country and getting out of the suburbia. But for now, this is what we've got, and this is what we do with it. Stay tuned for the bubbling event. All right, guys, you see it starting to bubble just a little bit in there. See at the edge of the pot, it's starting to roll. Getting a little pot bubble coming up in it. See it right there. It's getting to that point. It's fixing to start raging. About 5 more minutes. Once it raises up to right about up in here, it'll probably almost come out of the pot. I have to turn the heat down a little. And I'll boil it for 2 minutes after that. And I'll turn it off and start putting in the jars and do the hot water bath. Yeah, see, she's starting to bubble now. I'm gonna turn this off, and then when it gets to that point, I'll turn it back on and let you see what that looks like. All right, I'm back. You can just watch this, how it raises up. Remember that line right there? It's almost up there. There now, baby. Look at that. Wee! It's boiling now. I'm gonna turn this off and keep an eye where I can stir this, and I'll get back with you in a minute. All right, guys, that's boiled down. I'm gonna stir it down a little longer. And I'll skim a little bit of this foam off of here. But take a look at that. Got a pretty orange color. Make a nice looking jam. If you didn't hear before, this is the native plums to the southeast, and they grow all the way up into Tennessee. When I lived there, they just grow wild on roadsides in the woods. But we got these from the, where we get these from?
Extension Service.
Extension Service here several years ago.
During
the Arbor Day.
Yep.
But they've done really good in this area.
Too good.
Yeah, they do too good. They spread. They'll, if you want a lot of these, if you got the land for them, they'll make a thicket. And but if you want to be able to pick them, you don't want to get them too thick, because they have thorns and they're kind of hard to get to then. So you want to keep them a little bit under control and just kind of mow the little ones that grow underneath.
Wild animals love them too.
Yeah, if you want to just also grow another area, you can just grow them as a thicket for cover for rabbits and deer and birds and all kind of different wildlife. They're good for that. But I'm gonna get off here and I'm gonna put these in jars and then I'll show you what it looks like when I put it in the hot water bath. All right, here we're gonna put our plum preserves jam into the jars. I gotta get me one of those stainless steel funnels. Mm-hmm. For right now, this one works.
What's it work?
No, it's not full yet. Just want to show you how I do that. But I'm gonna turn the camera off when I get all these full. Because it's just too hard to try to hold it and do it at the same time. I'll get back with you and show you with them full. Alright guys, got 13 half pints boiling in a hot water bath. About 2 inches of water over the top of them, and when they get done, we'll pull them out and let you see how pretty they are. Alright guys, check that out. 28 half pints of plum jam. Isn't that pretty? That's come from our plums that we have out in the yard. We've eaten a lot of them. I've just plucked and eat a bunch of them. The birds have got a bunch of them and what have you. But yeah, probably a rat or two got some of them. But we managed to get that much out of them. And it's always good to harvest what you're growing and be able to stand back and look at it after you're through. But that's it for this video. I hope you like it.
Ainda bem que agora encontrei você. Eu realmente não sei o que eu fiz pra merecer você, porque ninguém.